about pizza. It makes the best pizza I've ever had. Now, this is my almost instant pizza dough, and the recipe comes with it. All you have to do is pop it in there and then put whatever toppings you like. It's a personal pizza, so you don't have to wait for the delivery man, pay extra for all the toppings.
No tip for the driver here
either. Exactly. Now, this is that reduced-fat turkey pepperoni. You'll never tell the difference, except it's not so greasy.
So we're
eating healthy. Saving a lot of calories. A little light mozzarella. Do you like peppers?
Sure.
Okay, and how about some
olives?
Throw
it on. Oh, more toppings.
Okay, that pizza's gonna take 7 minutes, and we've got a built-in timer, so I just set it for 7 minutes, and it'll call me when the pizza's done. And the go part is, see the green light?
Uh-huh.
That green light comes on, you know your machine is preheated and ready to start cooking.
Ready, set, go. Wow, a lot of improvements here, Kathy.
And a lot of possibilities. Now, you don't always have to use pizza dough. Like, look here, these are corn tortillas. I'm gonna make kind of a Mexican stacked pizza. And what I did was I just spread some beans on this corn tortilla, and we're gonna just drop it right in there.
Fits perfectly.
Now I'm gonna stack another one on top of that, and now we're just gonna put on some meat. This is a great way to get rid of leftovers. So, got a little cheese on there. And this one's only going to take about 5 minutes. So, I can set that timer for 5 minutes. And now I don't lose track of what's cooking. Have you ever had a Hawaiian pizza?
I know they exist.
Okay, this is pita bread. And it tastes almost exactly like pizza crust.
So, you got a pita pizza?
Pita pizza, that's right. Now, just drop that in there. Now, all you have to do is add your toppings.
Mm-hmm. Okay, just swish it around
it
there.
Yeah, exactly. In this case, I'm going to use Canadian bacon.
Okay.
So we just make like a little pinwheel of that around there. So we got some cheese here. You want to add the pineapple?
Sure. Just scoop out a couple of
chunks on there.
Right here.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can have exactly what you want on it. And that's going to take, again, about only 5 minutes because the crust is basically already cooked.
This is all great, but I think all of us are really going to miss cooking those side-by-side meals you used to show us.
Oh, I don't think you're going to miss it at all. Come on, let me show you something. Is this what you thought you were going to miss? This is the new insertable divider pan, and it goes in just like that.
So now you've got two machines.
And it's still the world's best no-fold omelet maker.
Love those omelets.
I do, too. This is just two beaten eggs, and I'm going to divide it between the wells just like this. So for the guys, you like those meat and potato omelets?
Yep.
Some steak and some potatoes, a few mushrooms. And on the other side, how about a veggie omelet? This is mushrooms and peppers and onions. Now I'm going to just put a little cheese on top. And close that lid.
And neatness doesn't count. I remember you said that. Now that's going to rise up again.
It's going to rise up, and in 7 minutes, we're going to have a perfect omelet.
Cooking from top to bottom.
Now, how about a weekend breakfast? How about some stuffed French toast?
Oh, stuffed French toast? I've never heard of that one.
Oh, it's delicious. I bought this extra thick bread. I've spread it with a little cream cheese and some strawberry jam. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and use this egg substitute. So just roll that sandwich in that egg batter. And in this case, now I'm using the entire cooking area of the machine. That's going to take about 5 minutes. So I just set the timer for 5 minutes. And how about some lunch?
I'm ready.
Okay, well, I'm going to make you a grilled sandwich. So I've just got a nice piece of French bread here. I'm going to put on a little ham and some cheese and some tomatoes and the top. Now, I like to brush it with just a little bit of olive oil, which is very healthy for you.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll pop that right in there.
Hey, this is like a panini.
And that'll cook in just about 5 minutes. So we'll set that timer. And over here, I'm going to make two sandwiches at once, so I've got the divider in. Now, you like wraps?
Yeah.
This is pastrami, so I'm going to put a little bit of mustard on it first. You can use the different colored tortillas, the red and the green tortillas.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And I'm just going to lay that on there. Oh,
okay,
yeah.
That's good lean meat, too.
And some Swiss cheese.
Sure, pastrami
Can't
and Swiss.
Can't have pastrami without pickles, right? All you do is fold in the sides and roll it up. Now, don't try to miniaturize the food because this has got plenty of room and you've got a nice deep well top and bottom.
And it's got the hinged lid so it'll raise
exactly.
up.
Exactly. Now, how about a corn dog?
Oh, I love corn dogs. It reminds me of being at the fair.
Well, you're just a big kid. I know that.
I am.
Now, just like if I was cooking this in the oven, I'd spray the pan. I'm going to spray my express. That way there's no sticking ever. Now, when I make a corn dog personally, I put the whole hot dog in, but a friend of mine says they like it cut up because that way they get dog in every bite. So, like
so
that.
You got the whole pack in there.
It all works just like that. And close that lid. About 7 minutes.
All right. Ready, set, go.
Ready, set, go. Ah, that's your pizza calling you. Come on.
Okay. Kathy, it smells like a pizzeria in here.
Oh, I know, but it doesn't cost like a pizzeria in here because these pizzas cost about $1 each. Look at this, a perfect personal pizza with exactly what you want on it. That's our Hawaiian with the Canadian bacon and a pineapple. And now how about our stacked pizza? Look
at that. Stacked pizza.
Now that's our tortillas with our beans and meat.
Kathy, that smell is
unbelievable. Oh, it does. Doesn't it smell great? I'm going to add on a little bit of lettuce and tomato.
Get this.
And my daughter made this up. These are crushed nacho chips, and it just gives it a little zing.
Fiesta.
Fiesta, exactly. Now, right on time, here's our pepperoni pizza. Now, this is your traditional pepperoni pizza.
And that dough smells so good. It's so fresh
smelling. Wait till you taste. Now, this is just, and can you hear how crisp it is?
I heard the crunch.
Listen to that crunch.
Are you finally going to feed me here?
I am, but it's going to be really hot.
I'm going to jump in and eat it. So fresh, so crisp, and so gooey on the top.
And believe it or not, that's under 200 calories and only about a dollar. Sounds like breakfast is ready. You know, people love omelets, but a lot of people are afraid to make them. But look how easy they come out in here.
Kathy,
isn't that beautiful?
Beautiful.
No folding. And another thing you're going to love about the insertable divider pan is that it makes it a lot easier to serve. And look, this just pop right out and onto the plate. That's our meat lover's omelet. And here's our vegetarian omelet. And look how they just come right out.
Look at that. No cleanup.
That would just wipe out with a damp cloth, but you know, it'll go in the dishwasher. It's wonderful.
More versatility for
Absolutely.
You there.
Okay, look, here's our French toast.
Stuffed French toast.
Exactly. And remember, I can utilize the whole base and the other side of the spatula that lifts the larger things. And look at this. Now, wait till I cut into this. Remember, this has the stuffing of the cream cheese and the strawberries, and it's hot.
Oh,
does that look delicious? Yeah, we barely had time for breakfast, and now lunch is ready. Now, you remember, this was our grilled sandwich.
Oh, look at that. Our panini.
Beautiful? Right. Now, I'm going to use the large side of the spatula and just lift that onto the cutting board. And I want you to see that it is just chock full of stuff. Doesn't that look delicious? So crisp and so delicious. All right, now look over here, because here's our corn dog.
There it is. Look at all those little guys in there.
I'm
they popped
you,
right out.
You can have it fast and easy just like that. And my kids like a little bit of mustard to dip it in as they eat it. And now this is our pastrami wrap. Let's cut into that guy and see what we got. Oh, look how full that is. Doesn't that look delicious?
Look at that. It smells like a deli in here.
That's
wonderful.
I love a good wrap. Now, are you ready for some dinner?
I'm always ready
for food.
All
right, come on down here.
Wait a minute. Now, you're going to put a steak in this?
I would put my Ready, Set, Go steak up against the finest restaurant and win. All right, now I'm just brushing it with a little bit of steak sauce, and we're just going to put it right in the machine.
And
it goes.
The divider is out, so you have the full cooking area now
you can use. You hear that sizzling?
Wow.
You like onions and mushrooms?
Sure.
So I'm going to cut up this mushroom and onion.
Okay.
Now let me turn this over. I want to show you how much sear we've got already on that steak.
Look at that. So this does heat up quickly.
Oh, it does. Now I'm just going to go ahead and put in those mushrooms and onions. And that's going to cook to medium in about 7 to 8 minutes. Now, how about some unfried fried chicken? Fried chicken is so delicious and so much fat. I've got a skinless breast and some legs, and I'm going to just roll them in some crushed up cereal crumbs. You can use any kind of cereal you want. Just crush it up real fine. Now, the only oil I'm going to use for this chicken is a little nonstick spray.
No deep fat fryer, no warming the oven up.
No deep fat frying, exactly.
All right in this. Look at this.
And you know, without that divider,
you've got 25% more room.
Three big pieces of chicken in there.
And it all fits.
Now, all these recipes are in the cookbook with times. That chicken is going to take about 10 to 12 minutes, depending on how big the pieces are, okay? All right, now over here, I've got a full course meal.
And there's our divider.
And a side dish. These are pork tenderloin medallions that I've marinated in a little teriyaki. Listen to that sizzle. Now, for a side dish for pork, I love sweet potatoes. So I've got some sweet potatoes and apple pieces mixed up together with a little bit of brown sugar. And that is going to cook in about 8 minutes.
All right.
It's not like cooking in the microwave where the food comes out rubbery. It's juicy, it's warm, and in fact, being able to cook with a little bit of oil is a good healthy habit for me and my kids, for my husband watching our weight, trying to get healthy.
For the working person, very fast. Just frees you up from everything. And then all your dishes throw in the dishwasher and you're done.
It's got a timer on it. It tells you when to put things in. It's quick. And when you finish, you don't have to clean it up. It's great.
This is the mini food pan, and it's probably my favorite because it'll just cook everything. Like, for instance, cinnamon rolls. I love to make cinnamon rolls in the morning for the kids, but who wants to heat up that big old oven to 400 degrees and then bake them for 15 minutes? So in here, I just spray it with a little nonstick. I cut each cinnamon rolls into three pieces, so now we're going to make cinny minis, and these only take 4 minutes. Remember, it's ready, set, 4 minutes to go. Okay. Now over here, I've got some little smoky sizzling in there. I'm going to make some pigs in a blanket. My grandkids love these. And while I do this, if you could go back to the refrigerator and bring me a pan you'll find in there.
Okay.
I've just got some pancake mix and I'm going to pour it right over those little smoky links. And these are going to make great finger food. I find that little kids really would rather eat with their fingers. Okay. And those will bake in about 4 minutes.
All right.
You know what I did? At night before I go to bed, I take a frozen tater tot, drop it into each well, and then pour some egg over it and put it in the refrigerator. Then all I have to do is get up, pop it into the ready, set, go, and I'll have eggsters or potatoes and eggs in 4 minutes. Ready, set, go. Okay, now, how about some meatballs? I know you like meatballs.
Oh, Grandma Farrago's favorite.
Yes. These I made special low-cal meatballs. These are ground turkey. Less than 3 ingredients, my kind of recipe.
Wow,
formed
healthy
into meatballs,
for you.
Absolutely, and pop them right in there. Now, these are going to cook without watching, without rolling, without turning in just about 8 minutes.
You don't have to deep fry.
When you taste them, you won't even hardly tell the difference. Now, I've heard you're a bit of a party animal.
Yeah, as long as it's before 8 o'clock.
Well, you know, hors d'oeuvres go with a party, and what I've got here are some crab-stuffed mushrooms. All I do is mix up the stuffing and then top each one with a mushroom. So they're kind of upside down right now, but when they're done, we'll flip them over and we'll have hors d'oeuvres in about 4 minutes. It is so much fun.
4 minute hors d'oeuvres.
That's right.
All right, ready, set, go.
Oh, I think that steak is ready. Are you ready for that challenge?
Yep.
All right, and let's take a look.
Oh, look at that.
Can you smell that? Oh, man.
You said you'd put this steak up against any other steak?
I would
any
indeed.
Other way. The mushrooms have been caramelized with the onions.
Isn't
and
that beautiful?
7
I'm
going to
cut it right
steak.
Down the middle because I want you to see. Look at that. Oh. That's perfect medium steak. And now, if you like it a little more well done, you could leave it in a little bit longer. I'm just catch a little. Now, it's going to be hot.
Okay.
Are you
I'll
ready?
Be careful. Yeah, but it's worth it.
It's as good as a restaurant steak, is it not?
Kathy, you met the challenge. Excellent. Excellent steak.
All right. Now, how about some chicken? And would you look at that?
Fantastic. Unfried fried chicken.
Unfried fried chicken. That's cut the fat way down.
That's a good size dinner.
That's a great looking dinner, isn't it?
That's
okay.
Beautiful.
Now, over here, this is the pork. And again, I love the fact that I can take this out because it makes it so much easier to serve. I'm just going to put out that pork. And let's get those potatoes out. Those are sweet potatoes. Oh, they look delicious, don't they? You want a little taste?
Mm.
Isn't that delicious?
It's the most delicious program I've ever worked on.
All right, I want to show you a couple of ideas over here. This is an idea you're going to love. This is my leftover box. Leftovers make great pizzas. I'm going to make you a white pizza. Mm. For a white pizza, I'm just going to use a little ranch dressing. Just kind of. Now, let's look in the leftover box and see what needs to get used up. Here's some broccoli. This may be the only way you can get broccoli into your kids. I've got some shredded chicken here. Let's add that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and a little bit of mozzarella cheese. Getting rid of these leftovers. Think of the money I'm saving. 7 minutes.
Okay, 7 minutes.
Seven
pizza.
Minutes from pizza. All right. Oh, sounds like our minis are ready.
Okay.
All right, now this was city minis, yes. Okay, now look. Oh, aren't these cute?
Those are great.
Right?
Perfect.
Now these are our little pigs in a blanket. And I want you to see, because that's the pancake mix.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a little smoky in the bottom
look
of each
at
one.
That. Little doggy
and
in
you
there.
Put them out on the plate and the kids just dip them right in the syrup and eat them with their fingers.
What a
it's
fun
just
breakfast
a great
for
breakfast
kids.
For kids. These are the eggsters.
Right, the ones I brought from the fridge.
Right. We can just dump these right out onto the plate.
Okay.
Those are just little taters with the omelet around
uh-huh.
them. Kids love them. And this, because it comes out, will go right in the dishwasher. No cleanup at all. Now, all right, this is not your grandmother's meatballs.
Meatballs. This I've got to try.
All right. Now, I'm going to give you a tiny little bite of one of them.
Okay.
Just that's kind of cheating. And I'm going to put some of them on my spaghetti.
Mm.
Is that good? And remember, that's turkey.
So it's almost a health
so
food.
So, you know, you make those meatballs up ahead of time. When you get home from work, just pop them in the machine, and you've got dinner in 10 minutes. Now, over here, this is the party stuff, right?
Right. These were your stuffed mushroom caps.
These are the stuffed mushrooms. And again, because I can remove that insert, I can just put my plate right on there and flip it over. And look at that.
Wow.
That goes back in there because, you know, if you're having a party, there's nothing worse than cold, hot hors d'oeuvres. So we can just...
You know, Kathy, this is absolutely remarkable, but... Have you been holding something back from me? Like dessert?
Well, I have some very special desserts. Come on over here and I'll show you. This first one I've got, it's kind of a giant cookie pizza. I call it a cookizza. Just mix up your favorite cookie dough. This happens to be oatmeal chocolate chip. Anytime you need a quick dessert, pop it right in just like this.
Look at that, a cookizza right into the well.
Right in the well in 4 minutes.
Oh.
Now, I know you love chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
I heard this is your dad's favorite.
Dad loves this one and he's got those little candy bars all
over
right. the house.
All right, candy bar filled cakes. There is a recipe that tells you how to take a box cake mix and split it into thirds. So you just fill the wells. And now on this side, I'm just going to put a little candy bar treat. Now, this is really going to be a mystery dessert because I have no idea what flavor this is. Into that same chocolate cake, I've got coconut macaroons right down the middle. So we're going to set, close the lid, set the timer for 7 minutes.
Two different kinds of desserts.
Now, come on over here because I got something really special to show you. There's lots of different insert pans that'll go in here. This happens to be the full round insertable. And I like this because I use it for my world famous upside down cake. Uh-huh. So in the bottom, I've got some butter and some brown sugar. And I'm just going to put 3 pineapple rings. This will serve 3 to 6 people, depending on who those people are. Okay, so I have the pineapple rings and a little cherry in the middle of each one. And this is just a yellow box cake mix. So you just fill it, pop it in there. And that's going to bake for 7 minutes.
And you didn't have to heat up the whole oven.
And that's going to save you a lot of money on energy. Oop, I think our leftover makeover is done. Okay, smells good in here.
And
there's our white pizza.
Wow.
Now remember, we made this with leftovers, things you normally would have just thrown out. So it's really good for the budget. And wait until you taste it. Ugh. Can you hear how crunchy that is? I know you want to taste
this. Yeah, I am kind of a pizza fan.
Give that a try. Is that good?
You know, this does not taste like leftovers. It tastes like a freshly cooked meal.
So you're loving the Express Ready, Set, Go now as much as I do?
I am, and I'm going to have another bite of pizza.
Okay.